But there were a lot of pointless scenes. Like with boss fights. The first boss fight, this is not really a spoiler because you saw it in some trailers. You get to fight Solomon Grundy. I thought that was pretty pointless. So Penguin just kept him down there in a museum. It was kind of silly. Also, I thought it was really weird that, that he was in the game, because I thought he was a Superman villain. Isn't Solomon Grundy a Superman villain? Or a Flash villain? Or a Green Lantern or something like that? I don't remember him being a villain. Me, I never fought him. Well, I did, but Clark was with me, and Barry, and Hal Jordan, and Diana, and they were all there with me, so I don't know. Also, another pointless fight that I thought was... Also, another boss fight that I thought could have been left out was Mr. Freeze. A lot of people thought that the boss fight was unique. The boss fight was so much different than the other boss fights. I completely agree. I had fun, but I thought it was pointless. Because here's him. Like, okay, here's me.
Freeze. Here's Ra's al Ghul's DNA. Perfect, Batman. Actually, no, screw you. I'm gonna break your cure that I made for you with Ra's al Ghul's DNA, and I will kill you unless you find my wife, Nora. She was taken from me by the clown. No! Screw you! Then you will die.
And after I kick his ass!
Oh, I'm sorry, Batman. I'll find my wife, Nora. Oh, God.
I'm guessing they just wanted to, you know, just make you fight Mr. Freeze for some reason. I don't know. I thought that was kind of pointless. But overall, I thought this game was great. And I really cannot wait for the new Batman game. After they make a Superman game. Oh, come on! You know it! They were just slapping the name Metropolis all over this game. And there was rumors going around saying that the next Superman game was going to be made by Rocksteady, and the game was going to be called Superman Metropolis. So, you know they got to do a Superman game. And, yeah, I think Clark should get one, because all his games freaking suck. Superman Returns was alright. Superman Man of Steel, it was okay. Superman 64, we ain't talking about that. Oh no, speaking of Superman 64, there was something. The AR training, or Wayne Tech something. There's like some type of training where you can fly after you complete it. You'll be able to use your grapple a lot faster when you're gliding. I felt like I was playing Superman 64. Why? You had to go through rings. It was like, floom, floom, floom. Oh, I failed. Try again. So that was pretty annoying, but it was worth it, because the grapple, you go faster. That was pretty cool. I love the grappling in this game. The grappling is very sweet. It definitely has improved for Batman Arkham Asylum, because Arkham Asylum, you can only go this. Here. That's awesome. I've always wanted an open world video game version of me. We finally got one. And that is awesome. And what makes me very happy, Spider-Man had a game coming out this year, Edge of Time. Guess what? That game sucked ass. And guess what? My game is the Game of the Year contestant. Score! What, Spider-Man fans? What you got? What you got about me, huh? What you got? Your game sucked. Well, they tried. But still, I thought this game has improved, definitely. Okay, we're gonna talk about some of the spoilers in this video game. If you have not completed Batman Arkham City yet, or you did not get Arkham City yet, click the Mute logo when you see the Mute logo pop up. So, because we don't want any spoilers here. Alright, so Mute! Here we go. So after you find out that Ra's al Ghul was actually working with Hugo Strange to make this whole thing happen, Hugo Strange dies, unfortunately. No, he dies, good. After Roger Bill stabs him in the back, cause saying, "Oh, you failed me," or something like that. And then he says, then he sets a self-destruct button on the big tower there, cause that's where Hugo Strange is. Then, we both jump out of the building, Roger Bill dies, and I survive, but I'm still getting sick because Joker affected me with the same disease that he has. And I realize that Joker has kidnapped Roger Bill's daughter, Ta's al Ghul. So I'm running, you know, I'm gonna try to save her. And turns out that the clean version of Joker is actually Clayface. And you actually have to get the, and you have a boss fight with Clayface. Awesome boss fight. Definitely the best boss fight I've ever seen in a video game. Better than Batman Arkham, Arkham Asylum. I mean, I thought that boss fight was pretty weak, but it was awesome. And then comes a pretty shocking part. What happens is, I take the antidote, just half of it, so maybe if I wanted to, I would give it to the Joker. Idiot clown Prince of Crime stabs me in the shoulder. Therefore, I knock down the antidote and it spills all over. And then the Joker dies. And then I carry the Joker's body. I get out of Arkham City. Commissioner Gordon shows up. I put the body of the Joker in Commissioner Gordon's hood and in his car. And I walk away. And then the game ends. The death of the Joker is so much different than the other deaths we've seen. Oh, we've seen him blown up. We've seen him fall down. We've seen him shot. We've seen him electrocuted. But never, never have we seen him die of cancer. So, that was pretty unique in Rocksteady's part. They had big balls to do that. So, alright, unmute. Now this part I do want to talk about is not really a spoiler, but after you beat the game, you get to hear Harley Quinn singing to a baby during the credits. Why? Because as soon as you complete the game, you get to go back to Joker's secret hideout to find some Riddler clues. By the way, that's another thing I had a lot of trouble with. The Riddler clues are kind of annoying. But moving on. Right near a statue of Harley Quinn's old outfit, like a model, like a little mannequin there, and it had Harley Quinn's old outfit. You look down, you see a pregnancy test. It's positive. That means Harley Quinn is pregnant with Joker's baby.
Oh my.
What? Oh boy. That made me laugh. And I don't laugh a lot, you guys know that. But that made me laugh. Alright. Let's go to ratings. Alright, now so let's talk about the ratings of this video game. I think this is definitely the game of the year. I think this game is fantastic. Although there are some troubles with the game. But all perfect things come with some very messed up things. Like very, you know, pointless stuff. Things that frustrate you in video games. So because of that, even though I think this is the game of the year, I'm going to have to give Batman Arkham City a 9 out of 10. So, Joker, Harley, what'd you think?
Overall, 9.5 out of 10.
I'm going to give Batman Arkham City a 10 out of 10. Yeah, because I'm cool like that. I can give that kind of stuff.
Alright. So, that is it for the first episode of Let's Talk Games with Batman
and Joker.
And Harley!
Shut up. And, hope you enjoyed it. I can't wait to do more. You will expect to see more episodes of Let's Talk Games with Batman around the holiday season, because that's when I'm going to get more games. Hope you enjoyed this review. I'll see you next. I'm sorry. Thinking about Joker and Harley Quinn's baby. It's gonna look ugly. Oh man, I can just imagine like Harley Quinn holding it and the baby's like, Cause I'm gonna be so retarded because both Joker and Harley Quinn are so stupid.
Oh, you know what, Betsy? I'm starting to get really peed off of you making fun of Harley, like you and me.
What are you gonna do about it?
We are just going to return the favor.
What?
Harley! Roll the clip that we found from Batman's 1945 cereal reels.
What are you doing?
You got it, Puddin'.
Top of the world, I'm rolling along, yes, rolling along, and I'm quitting the blues of the world, I'm singing a song,
yes, no, stop playing, song. Oh, God,
glory, hallelujah, just told the parson, hey, Paul, get ready to call, just like Humpty Dumpty, I'm going to fall, and I'm sitting on top of the world. I'm rolling along, don't want any million. I'm getting my share.
Stop laughing at me! Stop playing! Stop laughing at me!
Muscle Bruce, I'm so glad you're okay, Harry. You were out for quite a while.
Alfred! Holy crap! Wait a minute, what are you doing in my room?
I was cleaning the drawers, yes. I always do that while you're sleeping.
Oh man, Alfred. I just had a horrible dream. I had a dream that I did a review of Arkham City with Joker and Harley Quinn. It was horrible. But everything's fine. It's just a dream. Oh my god.
Master Bruce?
Hmm?
Do you mind telling me how this was leaked online?